Congratulations on your purchase of a new Eastwood MIG welder. We're going to take a few moments to guide you through the setup and usage of your new machine so you'll be able to start welding your thin sheet metal or steel projects up to 3/16 inch quickly and easily. The MIG 135 comes with 023 steel MIG wire, gas regulator, and instruction book. The only thing you'll need to do is rent a bottle of 75% CO2, 25% argon. Here's how to install the supplied MIG wire and tip in the machine. First, open the side panel to gain access to the wire drive mechanism. Note the reference chart on the inside of the door. Then feed the ground cable through the front of the machine and connect it to the proper terminal for your wire. The MIG 135 can use flux core or solid wire, and the reference chart shows the connections for each. Now feed the trigger wires and the torch connection through the unit and secure the torch with the wing nut. Plug in the two trigger wires as shown. The welder arrives with an 8-inch wire spool adapter installed. This adapter allows you to use larger spools of wire in the MIG 135. Remove it to use the supplied 023 wire spool. Before installing the spool, be sure the drive roller is matched to the wire size. The MIG 135 can handle several different wire sizes, and the roller is turned to the correct setting. The wire size options are found on the reference chart. When installing the wire spool, be sure not to over-tighten the retaining nut. The spool needs to spin freely for the best possible welding performance. The wire is then fed into the drive mechanism, guided over the drive roller, and fed into the torch sleeve. The pinch roller is snapped into place, and you can now turn on the welder and pull the trigger to begin feeding wire. The lower knob is the wire feed speed, and you can adjust it up to speed the process. Once the wire emerges from the end of the torch, turn off the machine and install the supplied tip and nozzle onto the torch. Now you can install the gas hose on the welder. It's a good idea to wrap the threads with gas-compatible thread tape. The regulator connects to your welding bottle and the hose connects to the regulator. Turn on the welder, open the gas bottle, and pull the trigger to begin gas flow. Then adjust the regulator to about 20 CFM for regular MIG welding jobs. Overhead welding or welding in windy conditions may require higher gas flow. Now you're ready to begin welding. Compare the steel thickness of your project to the settings on the chart, and match the welding amperage and wire speed to the recommended settings. Connect your ground wire and you're ready to go. All right, you can weld thin sheet metal with the MIG 135. What we have here is some 18 gauge. What we're gonna show you is our inner grips, setting the proper gap between the panels, and also the use of our copper weld backers, which goes behind your weld to back up the MIG puddle. Note how we're doing a series of tack welds on thin steel. This will keep the heat level down to prevent warping the panel. When finished, carefully grind the tack welds down to have continuous, clean weld joint. Now we'll move to some thicker stock. Again, check the settings on the chart to match your steel. You can apply clean, continuous beads on thicker steel without the risk of warping the material. I'm going to show you here how to fill a hole with the MIG welder. If you were to simply take your gun here, try to weld this, you're just going to blow wire right through the hole. What we're going to use is the welder's helper. Copper material simply backs up the hole and allows the MIG weld to penetrate and fill. The MIG 135 is a versatile machine that will allow you to repair body sheet metal, fabricate steel brackets with 110 power in your home shop. Be sure to check the Eastwood catalog or eastwood.com for replacement tips and wire, and to find other tools and welding accessories to help you with your restoration projects.